The Clef Grant Spin is a fun little multi-band rotary plugin. It has similarities to a Leslie speaker, but is not intended as an emulation. In this video, I will show you how it works and how to use it. Hi, I'm Marlon and this is the White Noise Studio. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you know when there's a new video online. The Clef Grant Spin is a rotary speaker plugin. Where this plugin is different from other rotary speaker plugins is the fact that it uses four bands instead of the usual, which usually are the horn and the rotor. Let's go over the sliders, buttons, dials and of course the sound. Here's the plugin. There are four bands with identical controls. You have the slow and fast sliders, with whom you set the slow setting and fast setting of the rotor you want. And you switch between the two speeds with the mode dial, which also has an off setting, which acts as a brake of the rotation. So that will slow the rotor down to zero. Engaging slow and going to fast. The rotor slides go from 0 Hz to 10 Hz for both fast and slow. It's not syncable to a BPM in any way. So the slow can have the fastest setting and the fast can have the slowest setting. They could have named it A and B instead, but I assume Clef Grant wanted to keep a sort of a rotary speaker reference. The wide range for both rotors also allows, with the four bands, to mix up the speeds. So one band can slow down while the other speeds up. You can get some nice creative effects with that. Here we have the size dial. This affects the Doppler effect of each band. The acceleration and deceleration dials set the time it takes to either speed up or slow down. The range is from 1 second to 10 seconds for both. The level is the volume control for each band. And then we have velocity. This dial sets how the volume of the input affects the speed of the rotor. And it works like this. On the mode selector, you choose slow or fast. On off, it doesn't work. Then you set the speed at either slow or fast slider. The slow slider only works in slow mode and the fast slider only works in fast mode. Then you set the velocity to a negative or positive setting. Negative means velocity will slow down the rotor and positive will mean it will speed up the rotor. Let me demonstrate. I've inserted spin in a post fader slot so I can use the fader to change the input gain of spin. And the input gain will determine how fast or how slow these rotors will spin. Okay, let's play it. So you can get really creative here. If you look here, there's a so-called needle which lets you see if this band is speeding up or slowing down to the desired rotating speed. These three switches set the crossover points between the bands. You can choose from two different frequencies for each band. In addition to the rotary effect, you can choose from three reverb room sizes and mix them in with a mix control. This This is the amp section to add saturation and overdrive to your rotary sound. This is clean and this is hot, and the amount of saturation can be adjusted here. And there are three simple tone control bands. And here you find the input gain, the output gain, and the stereo width control. I mentioned in my Eventide rotary plugin review, check it here, that a stereo width knob would be a welcome addition, because often with rotary plugins, people like it wide. And a spin plugin has that. Good one. And finally, this little knob changes the graphics on and off to save a bit of CPU if needed. There is no way of syncing this plugin to a BPM. You cannot solo or bypass a band, and you cannot change the number of bands. You cannot add any input manually by typing. It all has to be done by dials and sliders. It also doesn't have a dry-wet control for parallel usage. So you have to use an extra track for that, or use this plugin as a send effect. And the graphical interface is not resizable. But it is a lot of fun. Thank you for watching. Check out my review of the Eventide rotary plugin here. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel, and I'll see you next time. Bye!